random rumor that I read. Mm. You were shot at or shot?
Shot at, shot.
Ridiculous. How did that happen?
It was like the 1st of January 2007. Mm-hmm. You know, bullet is not like that. It's not like those things you see. Before you even think about it,
it's already happened.
My dashboard just
smashed.
And I discovered that the person that I was talking to, that I was telling not to give me that, I just came out of this place. It was on the floor already.
That is ridiculous.
So the next thing I remembered was I'd gone past the barrier. Mm-hmm. My car was like, the only thing stopping me was the wall. Mm-hmm. And I discovered that I was like, my head was on fire and my side was on fire. Okay, the bullet had, you know, I had this big afro. That caught, that.
The bullet went through your hair.
Yes, like there, I have this big scar here and I have one here. So that's all I can remember. So the next thing I heard was, go search. Mm-hmm. So somehow, I don't know how, I just put my head on the seat. Mm-hmm. I was, you know, in that moment, I was bleeding. Mm-hmm. I was bleeding and I discovered I was getting weak. As I was lying down there, I was getting weak. And I tried to open, because those ABS cars, I just came out from the window and started running. I started shouting, help me.
You did something the other day. You went around singing for people for free on their wedding day.
Just because I can.
Just because you can. And I saw that was the caption that you put. And I noticed it's something that you push forward a lot. That's a big part of your life, I'm assuming. Is it because of where you came from that you're trying to help people moving forward?
Sometimes you do it for the profit. Sometimes you do it just because you can. Mm-hmm. And it's just to put a smile. You know, sometimes the reward is just to see that deep, appreciative smile on someone's face for no reason. Like, you don't have to pay me, let me just do this for you.
Apart from photography, apart from the other stuff, what else do you guys like to do together, like in your free time? Like, I notice you guys are inseparable, so.
This day, she's really busy for me. She's too busy for you.
I don't know.
She's doing this skillskitchen.com things, an online learning platform.
Okay, we should
every
probably
time
check that out, yeah.
She's always on her laptop. Very soon, I'm going to call family meeting.
As in, it's very necessary. You've done pretty well on the African continent. I noticed recently you are all over the place internationally. You were in Hollywood.
I'm recording a Christmas album. I'm also putting together another international album. Okay. I like the smell of dollars.
It's nice, huh? Dollars are sweet. I love that. You met a couple of interesting people. Can you tell us a bit about that while you were there? So you met Cuba Gooding.
Yes. I went to a voice coach and mm-hmm. I met him there. I also met the music director, Nathan Gates, of Michael Jackson Thriller.
Exactly.
The people
exactly.
that played some of my new songs, they were those guys that played for Michael Jackson Thriller, mm-hmm. and they are the people that played for Quincy Jones and all that. So I was singing with the mic. They tell me, do you know who do you use this mic? I said, Celine Dion, Adele. I said, can I take it? And so this mic has been here like forever and all that. So it's little by little. I think every good thing will come.
How would you describe your journey if you just, how would you describe the journey so far?
I always look at my life and I said, I don't think it's my strength. Okay. I don't think like I'm the best guy. But I think it is masterfully orchestrated by God. Okay.